Officials at the state's Public Utilities Commission have asked the Maine Attorney General to look into allegations that FairPoint Communications faked some test results to make it look like the company was ready to take over Verizon's landline operations. It is just the latest in a long line of well-publicized problems with the company. And Something News 8's Keith Baldi has more on now from the newsroom. And good evening to you, Keith.
Well, good evening, Tori. It's important to point out that the allegations are just that, allegations, and they do come from an anonymous source. But it just adds to the issues FairPoint has been having and also the growing image problem for a company that does not want to lose more customers.
2 years ago, the union representing telephone company workers throughout northern New England warned that a potential Verizon sale to FairPoint would be a disaster and lobbied hard against it. Now they say it's too late to do anything but support the company.
It's a hollow victory. Saying I told you so, because now we're in it together. We gotta make it work.
But making it work has not been easy. The massive back office system transfer and construction was wrought with problems, interrupting customer service and billing operations, and affecting some other small telephone companies that access the lines. Now, adding to the complications is an allegation made in an anonymous email to utilities regulators that FairPoint created a computer program to make it look like the company was ready to take over Verizon's operations when it wasn't, something Maine's Public Utilities Commission is investigating.
If the allegations are correct, it's concerning. However, the commission is reluctant to jump to conclusions based on an anonymous email.
In a statement from FairPoint today, a spokesperson says, quote, "We take these allegations seriously and are conducting an investigation of the allegations raised in the anonymous email." FairPoint says they'll respond by the end of the month, and the spokesperson says at the same time continue efforts to get their systems fully functional and restructure debt to be stronger financially, something on the minds of many who depend on the company.
Am I concerned about the company and work and all that? Yes, I am, but we still have to provide dial tone to, you know, the three states.
The State Public Utilities Commission says during the system changeover, when it's alleged FairPoint faked test results, there were people watching and watching closely to make sure it went to plan. Live in the newsroom, Keith Baldi, News 8.